biggest cities. Rioters have torched police precincts, killed people, at one point set up their own country inside Seattle. This has gone on for months. Why? Because we're allowing it to. You get what you put up with. That's the most basic law in life. We are afraid to stop this. If tomorrow the Washington Post described the rioters as white nationalists, he would be done by Friday, because every single one of them would be in jail. And by the way, we would support that. Anybody burning down American cities ought to be in jail. These are organized, but you're not seeing big criminal conspiracy cases against these people. Again, we're allowing it because we're too afraid to stop. That's the bottom line truth. None of that came up today when the Attorney General Bill Barr went before the House Judiciary Committee to talk about a bunch of different topics, but the violence did. Interestingly, the chairman of the committee, Jerry Nadler of New York, said he wasn't aware of the violence.
Protests had begun to wind down before you marched in and confronted the protesters. And the protesters aren't mobs. They are mothers, veterans, mayors. Now you are projecting fear and violence nationwide in pursuit of obvious political objectives. Shame on you, Mr. Barr.
In case Congressman Nadler is watching tonight, of course we fervently hope that he is, here are some pictures of those mothers and veterans protesting. It's the ongoing Joe Biden rally. It's going on for months, and it's working. Congressman Jim Jordan addressed it pretty directly in his opening statement.
I want to thank you for defending law enforcement, for pointing out what a crazy idea this defund the police idea, policy, whatever you want to call it, is, and standing up for the rule of law. And frankly, we have a video we want to show that gets right to this point. Can we play that video, please?
Never thought in my lifetime I would see such trash.
Interesting to know what Jerry Nadler thought of all of that, but apparently he wasn't watching. He didn't even engage with Jim Jordan's argument. Instead, he just attacked him.
Well, I hope that Mr. Jordan will never complain about the length of my opening statement.
Well, at least Nadler has been consistent. He's ignored the looting and lawlessness and rioting for quite some time. This is how he was responding when he was asked about it yesterday.
There's violence across the whole country. Do you disavow the violence from Antifa that's happening in Portland right now?
That's a myth that's being spread only in Washington, D.C.
Antifa in Portland?
Yes.
Sure, there's videos everywhere online. There's fires and riots.
Violence, like appendicitis, doesn't go away just because you ignore it. It tends to get much worse. There's only one thing that stops it, and that's policing, good policing. One unlikely success story, and a great one, is the city of Detroit. Somehow, Detroit has managed to keep a lid on violent protesters while allowing people their First Amendment rights to demonstrate. Rioters there have not looted or destroyed a single business in the city of Detroit. The city, of course, famous for its devastating riots of 1967. So how did Detroit do this? And why is nobody talking about it? The police chief of the city, James Craig, joins us tonight. Chief, thanks so much for coming on. So you've been coming on fairly regularly for the past couple of months. So we've been watching Detroit, and Detroit has this reputation going back 50 years of being a place where there are riots, but you haven't really had it. So it's worth finding out why.
You know, I appreciate that question, Tucker, because I am just ecstatic over the men and women of the Detroit Police Department. One thing I learned from my time in Los Angeles, we don't retreat here in Detroit. We're just not going to do it. You saw them in just occur of streets where there was lawlessness, looting, burning.
Yeah, it's funny how you hear about the stupidity and ignorance and assholery of Baltimore, Philly, Atlanta, Dallas, New York, Los Angeles, Portland, Seattle. What city is missing? Oh, that's right, Detroit. Detroit is the one city that you have not heard regarding any of this garbage. Case in point.
Misinformed, misguided leader of this radical fringe had the audacity to try to change the narrative. And I showed a video. You may be aware. I put the video out that clearly depicted officers who were faced with an imminent threat to their life. And this guy today, this same misinformed leader, is calling for my resignation. Detroit will have nothing of that. So when you talk about what's different here, we have a city that has stood together. And oh, by the way, I know there's a lot of conversation about the mayors in some of these big cities. Our mayor stands with this police chief, stands with this police department, that we are not going to tolerate this uptick in violence.
Amen.
That's key.
Amen.
That's real key.
This conversation is made by night. Chief Craig, congratulations on your success. It is so heartening. Detroit as a success story. Amen. Good for you. I hope
you'll
come back.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. I will always come back, Tucker.
Amen. Thank you.